Brittany Abrams, and what you're about to watch is a photo story dedicated to the book that I've been reading about leadership called Tribes, and it's written by Seth Godin. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Welcome back, and I hope you enjoyed my photo story of the book Tribes about leadership by Seth Godin. Basically, Seth wanted everyone to try to get out there and realize their potential, be an opportunist, and gather people who are like-minded to just create a very good movement, to create extraordinary things. He's saying that everyone should not just take it sitting down and just being a follower. Everyone should get out there and try to branch off and do their own thing. And I totally agree with this book. This book has taught me that with me going into the healthcare profession, there are people who are at the bottom of the totem pole and there are leaders. And you know, without a tribe, you can't be a leader. And being a leader, you have to have a tribe. So basically, try to work towards being a leader. Try working towards being more, extend your potential and just do better and be better you. So me going into the healthcare field, I see this as an opportunity to go out there and learn all the information, make myself more marketable, go out there and do the best that I can and be the best respiratory therapist that I can be. Not many people are willing to go out there and go through the discomfort of becoming a leader, the difficulties that it takes to be a leader. Actually, Steph mentioned that it's really not that difficult becoming a leader. Basically, you just have to
Being a leader, you have to
go out there and realize that things have to change. You have to be willing to go through the motions and go through the changes in order to form your movement and it be successful. In the book, Tribe, Steph urges that, you know, change is not bad. Leaders, real leaders, solid leaders make changes. Everyone might not like it, but if you have a solid tribe behind you, then
you have to realize
not everyone takes the opportunity. These people are called sheep walkers. These people are basically afraid to go above and beyond. And it has been some people who have been put in that mind frame that you're not a leader, you're not a natural born leader, you should just basically play your role and go down
the
urges that people challenge the status quo. To basically do more than what you see. To not what it's always seen, but just go out there and prevail. Be
it's
bigger
best
than what you are.
Your hope and optimism are matched.
So basically, with that being said, go out there, become a leader, be the best that you can be. I recommend that anyone read the book Tribes by Seth Godin that are the
Being a leader,
you have to go out there and realize that things have to change. You have to be willing to go through the motions and go through the changes in order to form your movement and it be successful. In the book Tribes, Steph urges that, you know, change is not bad. Leaders, real leaders, solid leaders make changes. Everyone might not like it, but if you have a solid tribe behind you, then it's bound
going
to happen.
Going to the healthcare field, as I mentioned before, you have to be susceptible to change. There's a lot of change that goes into being a health professional, and you have to be willing to be a leader and go out there and learn this information because it's to better your career. And I suggest that anyone that's going into the health field or anyone that's trying to be a leader or anyone who has doubt about their leadership potential, go and read Tribes. And I hope you guys enjoyed this and you have a good one.